Hey man, what's going on?
Not much. I'm actually packing up my mattress right now to ship out. I'm going 100% Kemper. Hey, by the way, you want to buy a pedal board?
No. Why are you selling your mattress?
Because the Kemper gets like 90% of the way there. Plus, I already profiled all my amps.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, good luck with selling it.
Huh. I guess I didn't consider the amp in the room feel.
What?
Yeah, I do like playing through amps sometimes.
Oh, you're not listening to me at all.
Yeah, I guess a couple of my guitar heroes like Blake Mills and John Mayer do play through guitar amps still.
I guess that's factually correct.
Dude, you actually just convinced me to not sell it.
No, I definitely think you should sell it.
Thanks, man. You get pretty good tone sometimes, too. I'll talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
In all seriousness, I've had friends ask if I'm gonna get rid of my amps, and honestly...
¿Por qué no los dos?
Amps and modelers have their own benefits and drawbacks, and I'm happy to have both. I really don't see this debate as a reason to choose one over the other. I can totally see using the Kemper a ton when gigs start coming back. But I also had a house show I played over the summer where I could barely hear the PA, and we weren't on in-ears, and I could really only hear the drummer and the bass player. I had to rely on only the song form to know where the song sections were and where to solo. If I had been playing through my Kemper to the mains, I could probably play the whole gig with a bad sound and not even know it. Some of the run-and-gun gigs are best with an amp, and sure I could get an FR-FR, but why should I have to if I have amps? So this might come with some scrutiny, so don't destroy me in the comments section, but I think there are a couple of amps that the Kemper doesn't even get in the ballpark of. I think it does a great Marshall, I think it does a great Vox, it honestly does a great Matchless, but I don't think it does the Two Rock thing yet. Even the Dumbletones kind of sound just not exciting for being one of the most overhyped amps of all time. Granted, I've only played through one Dumble and it was a modified Vibralux, but it had a thing, and I just couldn't feel that in the Dumble profiles. Can it capture the vibe of an old Tweed Champ? Maybe. Can it get the Filmo sound touch sensitivity? Actually, yeah, it does a pretty good job at doing that, and I made some profiles. Amps are cool. I like amps. It's fun to have amps and to use amps. Turning knobs, hearing the speaker, it's great. I bought a new amp last week, and I'll tell you this. I started hearing these rumors of a Kemper 2 in the last few weeks after I literally just got this one. And I kind of hope it's not coming. And on the other side of the coin, I got this Tone King here out of a trade when the other guy was maybe looking at a Tone King Mark II. And the original Tone King is awesome. I still feel like it's valuable even though there's an updated model. Digital stuff goes out. I mean, is anyone looking to buy a PlayStation 4 right now? Also, in the last few weeks, we saw an explosion of content regarding the Neural DSP Quad Cortex. That's gonna be the newest rig simulation technology we've seen so far, and it'll probably beat out all the other amp modelers and amp profilers to some degree. That is until the next best thing comes out. But do you know what these profilers and modelers all need to be viable in the market? Amps. Yeah, regular old tube amps to profile and emulate. So no, I'm not going to be getting rid of my amps. I mentioned how interested in the profiling technology I am with the Kemper, and I've been making profiles of my amps and seeing how close I can get it. In the last Kemper video, I gave out a few free Tone King profiles, and I actually have a free Filmosound profile for you today. Here's the thing though, I'm working on putting together a Filmosound pack that takes it from a Tweed Deluxe all the way to Dumble Overdrive Special. I mean, it is very versatile. And this profile is part of it. So I'm only going to be making it available for download for the next 2 weeks. That's 14 days. If you're watching this after that time frame, keep an eye out for the Filmosound pack because it's going to be killer. But in the meantime, let me know down below what you think about it. As always, thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.